Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ولن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف عنها الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. يقول ربنا جل وعلا في محكم كتابه آمرا عباده بالتقوى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويقول جل وعلا: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ومن يطع الله ورسوله له فقد فاز فوزا عظيما، الفوز بالجنة أيها الأحبة. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله جل وعلا، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أعاذنا الله وإياكم منها، وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما تعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. ثم أما بعد، dear brothers and sisters, praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praise be only to Him, whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided to the right path, there is no one can cause him astray, and whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let him go to the right, let him go astray, there is no one can guide him to the right path. And I bear witness that there is no God between your ship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam is Allah's messenger and Allah's prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him with the last message to all kind of jinn, all kind of ins, to take them out of darkness, to lightness, out of worshipping thousands of idols, to worship only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed in the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed in the Holy Quran, He is the one, the provider who provides us from His provision, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He created us just to worship Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't need a provision from us, or to feed Him, or to feed ourselves, or to feed any of His creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But He is the provider who has all the power between His hands, who is the most strong, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if he decreed that, he is a provider, we don't have to fear for our provision. Because it's coming for sure from the Creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts this provision in a hand of a human, in a hand of jinn, in a hand of person, can He be just to give everyone, to provide everyone with whatever he has to give? It will be corruption for sure. It will be wrong for sure. It will be dhulm and dhulmat between the people, and the tadallum between the people. Even forgetting, he will forget one and give the other. Even miss someone and go to the other. But subhanallah la yansa wa la yanam. Subhanallah who doesn't forget. Subhanallah who doesn't miss. Subhanallah who knows it's just to give everybody his needs, and he knows how much do you need to make you the right person. He knows how much he has to give you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا مِنْ دَبَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ يُزْكُرْهُ وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَهُ مُسْتَوْدَعُ. There is no any living creation moving on earth but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide that creation. The provision for that creation, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed in the Holy Quran, with His own word, it is on Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the provider to provide this creation, and He knows where is the dwelling place for that creation. Where is its deposit? If it is in a uterus of a woman, if it is in a grave under the ground, if it is in a mountain under the water, wherever it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows where is that, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the provider who's going to provide that creation. وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ دَبَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلَ رُزْقُهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ. Whichever living, moving creation on earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot carry its provision. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided that creation. And as that He provides you, وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And Allah is our hearer, our knower, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we don't have to fear for our risk. We don't have to say, I am waiting for my risk and it didn't come, so I speed it. When I speed it, the shaitan comes and make me take it from the wrong way, not the halal way. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us in the Holy Quran.
And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his footsteps. If we follow it, we see how he guided us, how to get our risk from a halal way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with us to give us that risk. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is the method to get that risk in a halal way and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased to give it to us? Number one is taqwa Allah azza wa jal. To fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To have a piety in your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi sirri wal alam. Secretly and openly to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't say, I am nobody is watching me. But there is one is always watching you, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anywhere you are, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. So always, اعبد الله كأنك تراه. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have that piety in your heart as if you see him. فإن لم تكن تراه, if you don't see him, فإنه يراك. So he sees you, he's watching you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is taqwa. That is taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed in the Holy Quran. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. You see where is the risk coming? If you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you have the piety in your heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you follow the Islamic monotheism and believe in Allah and His word and punishment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find you a way of every difficulty that you have, any problem that you have. Not only that, وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you from a source that you cannot imagine that provision is coming to you from. وَاللَّهِ إِنَّ هَذَا لَحَقٌّ. Just do and watch yourself and see, subhanallah, I did that, and it's true. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, it's coming from where I never expected to come. Watch yourself. And do, practice, and see if it's going to come true or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Subhanallah. And if the people of towns, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are fighting in their hearts for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open from heavens and the air, blessing to be on them. Subhanallah. That is number one, taqwa. Number two, istighfar. Akthar min al-istighfar. Ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. سيد الاستغفار. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت, خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك وعدك ما استطعت, أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت, أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the master of استغفار, to make استغفار to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, to ask forgiveness from Allah سبحانه وتعالى, is this hadith. You find it in the small book, in the small book for دعاء. It is in English and in Arabic, and I'm sure it's more many languages too. أستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. Keep repeating استغفار as long as you are walking, lying down, sitting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said عن لسان نوح عليه السلام. What Nuh was guiding his people to, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Nuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. سبحان الله. Nuh, he said to his people, just ask for forgiveness from your Lord. استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا. He's all forgiven. What he will do if you make that استغفار? يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا. He will send the heavens upon you with abundant rain. What does the rain do? If we don't have this rain, how are we going to drink this water? How How the animal is going to drink to grow like that? We can eat that. How the plant is going to grow without that water? Subhanallah, the rain is everything. وَخَلَقْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Everything alive, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it from water. So, not only is it. Make istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will send the heavens with this abundant rain upon you, and يُرْسُلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Not only that, وَيُمْدِدِكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you. Will provide you with wealth and the kids. ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you fields and gardens and with fruits and rivers between it. That is provision. That is promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we make istighfar, we're going to be provided with whatever we need. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us all that. And also, Hud alayhi salam, he said, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيَرْزُقُكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ وَلَا تَتَوَلَّوْا مُجْرِمِينَ. Same thing. He ordered his people, Hud alayhi salam ordered his people also to ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send the heavens with the abundant rain and will give them, extend their power, more power. So everything, all provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Al-Qurtubi, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower blessing over his soul. Al-Qurtubi, you know that he has the big volumes of tafsir al-Qur'an. He said this is evidence about this ayat. He said this is evidence that istighfar bring that abundant rain to us from the heavens and give us that provision that يستجلب به الرزق ويستنزل به المطر يستنزل به الغيث. So if you make استغفار, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you this rain, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you with the rizq. And also in the hadith, it is the same meaning that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أكثر الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل هم من فرج ومن كل ضيق مخرجا ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. Whoever make a lot of استغفار, ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, more and more and more, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find him a way out of difficulties, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him, will provide him from a source that he doesn't imagine and he doesn't expect. Number three is حسن التوكل على الله عز وجل. And this is so beautiful, subhanAllah. Just look around you, brothers and sisters. Look around you and see how much dhulm between the people. People that you trust, people that you think they are good, and you think they are good in deen even. Some of them, they take the deen to hide behind it, to steal you, to rip you off. If they can eat you, they will. And this is because you trust them for something that you see in them that they are just. Can you imagine if you put this trust in someone who really, you can take this trust and he can be really trusted? How much comfort in your heart will be? Because you know, you trust him and he will give you. He will give you your rights. Subhanallah, it is a lot around us. You see lots of stories from the brothers and the sisters. They trusted people and the people, they didn't fulfill that trust. They cheated them. They steal their money. They do bad stuff to them. No trust. So who you can trust? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is tawakkul. Tawakkul, you trust, you put your trust, all your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. And he will provide you. He will give you the provision. But put all your trust on him. And be aware of one thing. Trust and the tawakkul is not a tawakkul. Tawakkul, you put in your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you take the ways and the methods and the reasons to get your provision. You didn't sit at home and say, Allahumma rizukni as Umar, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, Umar ibn Khattab. He say, Ya yajlis ahadukum wa yaqul Allahumma rizukni wa kama ta'lamun anna as-sama' la tumtir dhahaban wa la fidda. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, you sit and you say, oh Allah, provide me. And you're sitting, you don't go out to work. And you know that the sky is not gold or silver. So you have to go and take the method to get that. But the rest, the result, is not you. It's not on you. You don't know if you're going to get or not. You don't know how much you're going to get. But you put all your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will provide you, that's for sure. Because He promised that in the Holy Quran, that He is a provider and no one else. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِهِ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرُ تَغْدُو خِمَاصًا وَتَرُوحُ بِطَارٍ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if you really take Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and put all your trust in Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you in this case as He provides the birds. How the birds can provide themselves? They will go with empty stomach and they come back with full stomach. Who provides them? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول الحافظ ابن رجب هذا الحديث أصل في التوكل وأنه من أعظم الأسباب التي يستجاب بها الرزق. الحافظ ابن رجب, may Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless his soul, he said that this hadith is a base in توكل and you يستجلب به الرزق and you get your risk from that way, from that توكل, from that trust you put in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And some of the our salaf, they said توكل تصف إليك الأرزاق بلا تعب ولا تكلف. هل الله سبحانه وتعالى إن يترست put all your trust in Him, your risk will come to you without tiredness. It will come to you. And as we say that tawakkul, it doesn't go against the ways to go and get your risk. You don't sit and say, oh Allah provide me, because Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in the Holy Quran in Surah Al-Mulk, هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض دلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه. الله سبحانه وتعالى is the one who made this earth like that, staying calm under our feet, to walk in it, to go through the ways of this earth to find what we need. فامشوا في مناكبها, go in its ways, وكلوا من رزقه, and eat from the risk, the provisions that Allah سبحانه وتعالى provide you with. So means take the way to do, to ask for the risk, فَمْشُوا walk in the ways on earth that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it comfort like that for you, to walk on it and make it stays under your feet, and you plant in it, and you eat from it, and everything, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who make it like that. So take the way, the method, and go and look for your risk, and the result is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the provider. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, look at this ayah. وَأَخَرُونَ يَضْرِبُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَبْتَغُونَ مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَأَخَرُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking here in Surah Al-Muzammil about those. Some people, they look for their risk. They walk, take the walking on earth and looking for their risk. And He gathered them with the others who fight for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making jihad. As Al-Qurtubi, رحمه الله, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his soul, he said that this ayah is a dalil, is evidence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala سوى بين الكسب الحلال والجهاد في سبيل الله. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala جمعهم together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gathered those two together in this ayah. وآخرون, some they go, whoa, in earth they look for the provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide himself, provide their families, not only that, and provide the people, the needy, who need that, to give those people, to give the help to those people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better deal with who? With the people who fight for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's making jihad. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them equal. This is why some people, they tell you, al-amal ibadah, al-amal jihad. Yes, that's what al-Qurtubi, sahib al-tafsir, he said that in this, about this ayat. So, one man, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I leave my camel there, and I put my trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said to him, no, i'qilha wa tawakkal, tie your camel, and then put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is that? That means we take reasons, we take ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide us with to do, to get what we need. We don't make the work, we don't just leave everything like that and sit and say, oh, Allah provide me. No, this ways is from ta'a, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the tawakkul, the tawakkul ala Allah, you take Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All in your trust, that is iman. So, looking and taking the ways is with your body, with your limbs. You're taking the roads to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to do. And to do tawakkul, to take Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your trust. So the first one is obedient, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from obedience to Him. And the second one is iman. to put all your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have that tawakkul, it is iman in your heart, fil qalb, imanun fil qalb, billah azza wa jal, that He is the provider, He is the one who's going to provide you. Number four, silat al-rahim. Silat al-rahim, that is the relations, the family relations, the family ties. How do you ask about your people? How you do that? You always, you have people around you. You have families, you have father, mother, sister, brother, nephew, niece, you have aunt, uncle. Do you ask about them? Maybe they need your help. They don't live with you here? Give them a call back home. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us for that. Maybe they need you. They need only maybe the word is from you to hear it from you. So talk to them. Maybe they need your help. So you send him what they need. Relationship. Family is a relation. Family is ties. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من سره أن يبسط له في رزقه وينسأ له في أثره فليصل رحمه. That one who will love that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him more time in his life and more rizq, more provision. So get in connection with your family ties and family relation. أقول قولي هذا أصلاح الله أكبر. الحمد لله على إحساني وشكر له على توفيقه وامتناني وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أن لا إله إلا هو. Dear brothers and sisters, as it came in the hadith and Ibn Hibban, إن أعجل الطاعة ثوابا صلة الرحم. The one that you do and it came, the reward came very fast to you, is that Salat al-Rahim. To connect with your relatives, to do your family relations and family ties, to get with them, speak to them, help them, that is Salat al-Rahim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away provide you, reward you for what you do, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, even the fajra, in one home, the sinners who are in one home, but they get that surat al-rahim, they never need anything. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides him because of their salat al-rahim that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides him, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying in this hadith, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides him in provision and provides him even in kids. Number five, al-infaqu fi sabilillah. That you spend from your wealth in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the halal ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be sure, make it in your mind that in the day of judgment you will be asking about that wealth. From where you get it? How did you make it safe for that? How did you earn that? From a halal way or haram way? And how did you spend it? Where did you spend it? In a ta'ah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being obedient to Him, and in the ways, the roads that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to do that or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ. Whatever you spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace it for you. So that is provision. Allah will provide you. انفق. انفق عليك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in al-hadith al-Qudsi, spend on my side and I will spend on you, I will replace it for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. Subhanallah, yes, الشيطان always promised us and treating us with poorness. No, don't spend. You're going to need it. Don't give it. No. Just keep it. Tomorrow you're going to need it. Shaitan. Devil. He wants you to, where he wants you to go? He wants us to go to Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And he ordered you to be sinners, to commit sins. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, two and the two. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you with والله يعدكم مغفرة. So he, the shaitan, wants you to sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise you with مغفرة, with forgiveness for the sins that you commit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides you from his bounties. And the shaitan tell you keep it. It is, he promise you poorness, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise you with bounties from him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number six is al-ihsan ila al-du'afa. We have to take care of the poor, of the needy. Always get around those. And number seven, al-istiqama ala deenillah azza wa jal. And this al-istiqama, of course, al-istiqama is everything in our deen. Al-istiqama, to be stood fast on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the Islamic qualities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to be. That is, it has the whole religion between our hands. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us all and make all us follow the steps of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follow the ayat, the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Holy Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ihdina, Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana ya Rabbana fi man tawallayt, wa barik illahumma lana fi ma a'tayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma ij'al jam'ana hadha jam'an marhuma, waj'al tafarruqana min ba'dihi tafarruqan ma'suma, wa la taj'al fina wa la minna wa la baynina shaqiyyan wa la mahruman ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma ansur al-islam wa a'izz al-muslimin. Allahumma a'lin bi fadlika kalimat al-haqq wa ad-din. Allahumma ihzim a'da'aka a'da'ana a'da' ad-din. Allahumma aqsim lana min khashyatika ma tahurru bihi baynana wa bayna ma'siyatik, wa min ta'atika ma tuballighna bihi jannatak, wa min al-yaqin ma tuhawm bihi alayna masa'ib ad-dunya. Wa mat'ina Allahumma bi asma'ina wa absarina wa quwwatina ma ahyaytana, waj'alhu al-waritha minna, waj'al tharana 'ala man zalamana wa ansurna 'ala man 'adana, wa la taj'al musibatana fi dinina, wa la taj'al ad-dunya akbara hammina wa la mablagha 'ilmina, wa la tusallit 'alayna bi dhunubina man la yakhafuka wa la yarhamna ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma ighfir warham wa tajawaz 'amma ta'lam, innaka antal 'azizu al-akram. Wa sallallahu wa sallim wa barik 'ala sayyidina Muhammad, an-nabiyyil ummi wa 'ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim wa aqim as-salah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن